create a common API to use, right? So an API class, and export. And this is going to be import API. Import API extends API and has a super. As a super, okay. A unit tests executed problems. Right, so this is a simple problem. How about actually seeing some unit tests pass? None. Why none? Super expression must be either a null or a function. So no super. Oh. Super, and then the API needs to have its own constructor. Constructor. Nope. No idea what this means. Oops. Super expression must either be null or function. Came up on this a couple of days ago, but I don't remember. Not undefined in Linux line 27. Must be either null or a function, so this will not work. Expected to call super, and here I am calling super. Bah. Export default class point, export class, your export doesn't match your import. Import export class API. Import, the class, right. Okay, excellent. Import the class. So, I don't have anything here at the moment. Let's move some of the work. Let's move the request, this one, right? Into the API. And I will also need this guy. It. Right, no padded box, whatever that means. Type annotation is required, valid flow, so this is gonna be flow. Right. This works and this works. Let's see what else. Oof. Parsing the response. Let's see. Parsing the response. It's pretty generic. Pretty generic. I can probably maybe make it the JSON response parse or something, but definitely quite generic. Requests, and maybe let's make this a JSON parse, and here my response parse would be a JSON parse. Okay. Nonce. Ugly. Check rate limit, definitely can move. Here. Store and check per second rate limits. It. Удачи спать, сан. Я уже свое поспал сегодня. Как раз проснулся недавно. Пошел рано спать, проснулся, сейчас буду писать код. Сейчас. Let's pick a different API. Different API. Different API. BitPhoenix. BitPhoenix API. And let's create a BitPhoenix API. See what's that about. So, yeah. Common HTTP request methods into a superclass. Push. Synchronize. Okay, changes pushed. A new file, bitphoenix.com, no, JS, new file here. Bitfinex.js. Let's see if I have anything smart to take from here. Yeah. Probably something like that. And oh, I need to rename this one. Rename test. So we have Mocha, we have Sinon, we have Knock. I don't need Knock anymore. We need Bitfinex from Bitfinex. And I don't need any of these yet. A sandbox. No need for this. Scribe. Bitfinex API. Let's see. Describe Polonix. Describe. Yeah, I used the Fetero everywhere. Ugh, not so good. Anyway, we have the version 2 documentation. Bitfinex 2.0 API. Alright, so version 2 documentation. Let's see. What is it that they have here? The endpoint. It should define the API endpoint. Bitfinex, I need a new one, and endpoint, point equals to HTTPS API bitfinex.com v2. This test fail? It needs to fail. I want to see it fail. Come on. Ah, it doesn't fail. Ah, I don't think I have a class yet. So, export class extends API. Import API from API. Still it doesn't fail. Oh, here we go. Endpoint. Endpoint, fine. Constructor. Super. Endpoint API bitfinex.com v2. Why I will call it v2. I think. Yes, I will definitely call it v2. This is gonna be so annoying. Anyway, this is gonna be bitfinex v2 API. And import bitfinex v2. Great. That's from here. Oops, sorry. and it's not equal because one has a slash, the other doesn't. Excellent. First test passes. Amazing. Now, let's go. In order to offer the best service, we added the rate limit to the number. Rate limit policy can vary in range of 10 to 90 requests per minute, depending on some factors. Okay. What does it mean? Endpoints. So, oh, they have JavaScript examples. Excellent. You already have the request object available, URL available, use btc sds default symbol. This is the URL. All public endpoints use get requests. Okay, get tickers. Get tickers. So let's create a get the tickers. Describe tickers. And the ticker and the tickers traits. Tickers. Okay. It should return list of tickers the symbols you want information. Symbol bit, ask size, daily change. Tickers. So it should return a list of tickers and a fake get, which I don't yet have, should returns a response, which I didn't yet define, and the response is going to be something here, and my bitphoenix tickers equals this response. Now, how does the response look like? Try it. Let's see. Let's try and get. Boom! Oh! No, that doesn't look right. That doesn't look right at all. Forbidden. Why would they be forbidden? Ugh. Forbidden. Okay. This should be a simple get. So if I just open this in a... Alright. Symbols equals FUSD. T BTC USD. This is not very useful. Not useful at all, actually. I will most probably need to change this into something more useful. I mean, this is why I'm writing this, because all this knowledge needs to be in the API wrapper, and it's not there at the moment. Let's see, what should I see here? I should see here these things. Let expected be equal FRR. Bit period, bit size, ask period, ask size, daily change percent, last price, volume, high and low, whoops. Hi, come on. Hi, hello. This is what I'm supposed to see. And the response that I got was, if I ask just one, yeah, the response was this. And I want to see response 0 first, response 0 second, response 0 third. Getting out of hand. Response 0 13. Not a good number. Okay, some fixes. And now let's copy something from my previous tests. Not this, because this is the network. I don't need this. I need a test for a public API command. Let's grab that. So this is BitPhoenix, and I don't have dates yet. I have my BitPhoenix v2 instance, and I call it BitPhoenix, and I have my sandbox, which is my CNN, the import CNN. Yes, don't have dates yet. It should be only called once. Yes, it should be only called once. And my get gets overridden. And I should say that it was called with maybe path, because it is path tickers. Path tickers and query symbols equals FUSD. And this is when I'm passing in something like that. And this should be the response. And I should expect to see that returned. And it fails. Looks good. Looks good that it fails. Alright, tickers. Tickers should receive a list of tickers, so and it needs to return the get command with path tickers and query symbols equal to with a okay. Symbol should be equal to tickers join with a comma. Right, and then I should have get. Getting a path and a query, and I think I should pass it a path and a query. So this would be path, and this would be query. No. This is not a good query. This is gonna be query. Yes, this looks good. A path and a query. And this I can copy from my Poloniex implementation. Get. Oh, right. It needs to be async. Async. So, let's see. How am I getting this? There should be a path here and a query, and the query should be I don't know what, doesn't really matter at the moment, and I don't think I need all this check rate limiting stuff at the moment. I'm going to create options. The host is going to be this endpoint parsed as a URL. So I'm going to take this as a URL. Maybe I should Forced, should they call it? Endpoint URL, should they call it? New URL for this endpoint, and host should be endpoint URL host name. Alright, host name. And there's going to be a path as well. Path name. Right. This is good. So, host and path. This endpoint path joined with path joined with query string stringify, import query string from query string. Headers, everything. What's wrong with that? Oh, I need a space. Blech. Okay. What's this? Type annotation require valid flow declaration, right? Needs to be flow. I need to import URL, of course. URL from URL. Path is a string. This point endpoint. Endpoint is a string. Endpoint URL is a URL. Endpoint host is a string. Endpoint path is a string. What's wrong with these? Not in camel case. Oh my god. Must it be in camel case? Are you seriously? Fine, camel case. I don't mind. Camel case it and camel case this. I don't actually need to pass the URL here. Camel case this and looks okay, looks better. What's this? Rest parameters, missing annotation. An array of string. No? Yeah. Great. 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 Very good. And of course it's not equal because it returns me whatever I said that fake get returns. Ah, I don't need to return what fake get returns, I need to parse it. Yes, this is something that I need to do. So, let's see. Let response be equal to this. And I shall return if error response. No, I should return response 0, the name. The name is in the first place. This is gonna be so for ticker off response build heal the response. Jason. Ticker 0 equals ticker 0. This is going to be FRA. Actually, I need to check if they're the same. Don't even know. Simple bits. Oh my god, they are different. They are different. Are they completely different or just FRR? No, they are pretty much different. Okay, should I do this? I don't know. Yeah, I should do this. Maybe I should have raw tickers to return the raw response, and then I will have the JSON tickers to parse it into JSON. Yeah. That sounds better, actually. Let me just return the response. Create another method that returns the actual parsed response with all the attributes. Whoops. Okay, let's see. It should return the original response from tickers. Response would be this. Get returns the response and they should be return the response. And it should be called with right tickers and symbols FUSD. Right. Should this is stickers. Maybe I should make public API and the parsed public API. Should implement tickers. And it implements stickers. Should implement stickers JSON parsing. this is where I call my tickers JSON. And and expect it to return this. Right. I would actually, let's try another one. T. Let's try TBTCUSD. Yeah, these are different. Oh, so ugly. Okay, so I want both of these returned. Expect. What should I expect? I should expect FUSD to be this. And I should expect TBTCUSD to be something different. That's the problem. Property. Ah, yeah, that's because I have. Anyway, and this guy. Let's see. So in trading pairs, first of all of these gonna be. Come on. Come on. Seriously. Find res 0. In the selection, find res 0, replace res 1. Okay. I'm trading pairs. I have my symbol, which is this. This is gonna be a symbol. Press one. Results. And this is gonna be press zero results. And it has a bit. It has a bit size. It has an ask. It has a bit ask size. It has daily change, percent, less price, volume, high and low. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. What's the problem here? Computed property cannot be assigned with an array. Ugh. What do you mean? Ugh. Fine. How about now? It doesn't have a for hour. Right? This doesn't have a for hour. chase them. Response is going to be tickers. Chase is going to be built. Ticker of response. JSON. Ticker 0 is going to be equal to. It depends. If ticker 0 starts with. Do I have a starts with in JavaScript? I don't think so. Oh, you do have a starts with. Pretty. Starts with an F. It's a funding currency. If ticker 0 starts with an T. It's a trading pair. Trading pair. Funding currency. Else if any else ifs? No, else ifs. No. Just an else if. Else throw. Shall not copy paste. So hard to resist. I think I shall copy paste. It is a trading pair. That's why JSON ticker 0 is going to be equal to all of these properties of a trading pair, of which, come on, such a pain, of which in this I should replace result one with ticker 0. Ticker, just ticker. And for this, I shall replace ticker 0 equals. Response 0 would be replaced with a ticker. Okay. Right. Now, what the problem is. Let's see. It doesn't like my error strings. It does like every type. This type is incompatible with string, right, like that, and then ticker is not defined, of course. Let it be defined. And property iterable is not found in promise. Wait, definitely wait. And this is gonna be an async thing. Is this going to be an, it's gonna be an async thing as well. Must be. And this doesn't have to be async because there's a promise returned in there somewhere. Okay. Now I need to define JSON. FRR a number bit a number bit period a number bit size number ask number ask period a number ask size a number. Can I have a float? What are all of these? What are these? Blah. Just a number. Daily change. Daily change percent. Plus price. Volume. Doesn't like it. What object literal? I don't have an object literal. Ah, no. It's gonna be a string of these. Right. It's gonna be a string of these. Many strings. Many of these as well. Does it work now? It works. Excellent. Very ugly though. I don't have an await in my promise. Ugh. Exit, exit, exit. I need to await my expectation. Await. And await. And this has to be async. And this has to be async. Equal undefined typical maybe it shouldn't be async. Is it async? It is. Tickers is not async. I mean it is async. Behind all of that it is async, but JSON is definitely async. I mean undefined dip equal. There's a dip equal in there. It works on the previous test. throw reject, but just a regular throw would be fine. Maybe this should be a wait. No, here I do return a promise. I am not awaiting this promise. Here I am awaiting a promise, and I should maybe create a new promise instead. Only I'm okay, this doesn't make any sense. Undefined deep equal. What do you mean undefined deep equal? Line 36. Undefined deep equal. There's really nothing special here. It's just a deep equal on something that I await. Without await, it's a promise. So I await the promise and then I compare it to what I expect. Await BitPhoenix tickers JSON. FUSD. BTCUSD. This works, and this is going to be result. Does this work? Yes. Deep equal actual is the result. Expect is expect that typical actual expected and the message. Let's call this actual. This expected. Undefined. I think maybe I should return the JSON at the end. Or something like that. Like this maybe. Yeah, much better. Right. So this is going to be an array of strings. Tickers, list of trading pairs and hunting currencies, and let's copy. JSON. There's a JS doc reference, another function. location. See name path. See link bar, right? Just link bar. Just link. Helper function link ticker JSON. Annotates the result with attribute names. Great. Results from tickers using property names and result into a key value and array of key value. Pairs information about the trading pairs and holding. The C link tickers. Didn't work so well. C link tickers, okay. Returns and promise with tickers. Probably good. C promise, which will return either an array of objects of name to information objects or an error. Something like that. Promise. Polymorphic type. Can use for referable, so gonna be an array or error. How about that? Doesn't like it either. Polymorphic type, it is, but there must be a space before union type notation. Okay, how about now? Must be no space at the start of a generic. Okay, how about now? Array. Incorrect number of type parameters. Right. It's gonna be a string. No, actually, it's gonna be a string pointing to stuff. Yeah. Unexpected token. What did you expect? What? Oh no, this is a bug. It's definitely a string of stuff. Right. Right. Array of an object where strings map to more objects. Fugly. Does seem to look okay. What's up in here? It doesn't return the correct type. Oh, seriously. Incompatible with array type member 2. Error. Object type. This is incompatible with error. Because I'm not returning an error. I'm throwing a new error. So I don't have an error. I always return this. And I just throw errors. Right? Type is incompatible with array type none. It's a string of this stuff. The strings mapping to stuff. This is what I have. String mapping to stuff. Maybe. Don't tell me I need to be explicit about the stuff. That is going to be very ugly. Very ugly. Right. It is not returning an array. It is returning an object. It is returning an object. Right, returning an object. And not found in object type, not found in object type. What object type is that? Let's not be overly explicit. Let's just say, you know what? It's an object. Just don't fuss about it. It's an open-ended object. String. And on the other side of the string, there are more strings. I get what he's trying to say. There are more strings mapping to numbers. Right. This seems okay. So, property not found. Of course it's not found. I don't want you to find any properties. I want this to be simple, relatively speaking. Why does it think it's a number? It's not a number. What is result? It's any. pipes are just so hard. I get it why people don't like types. Loose typing is a blessing. Right. So this is a string. And this string has an object as its value, and in the object I have multiple strings with numbers as values. Makes perfect sense. Makes absolutely perfect sense. No reason for this to fail. Maybe I should be explicit about this as well. It's gonna be like that. Calculating flow and flow past. Yes. Yes. So this is gonna be string of number. Not an array. Actually, not an array at all. Not an array at all. Oh, no. This is gonna be an array string, but this is gonna be a promise that returns this stuff. Let's generate the documentation. Let's see, how do I define the class? Well, this is a class, and I need to define it. This is also a class. It has a client for the BitPhoenix REST API. Creator, that's fine, I don't need any of that. Don't need this, don't need that. Just create me a thing. Okay. I have my class, and I have my methods of the class, and the methods have documentation. Ooh. And this, of course, doesn't work. Do they have any kind of name here? No idea how this would work, but. So this would returns a promise which includes an array, and the array is of more arrays, an array of more arrays, and inside of that there are string or number. There's gonna be a link here to the public API reference. Let's see how this looks like in the documentation. Refresh tickers. Ooh, sexy. Very nice. Very nice. Almost 5 a.m. Okay. Let's check my code and see that Travis will not fall on its face. Lint. Great. Flow. Failed. Yarn flow status. Never mind, I think it will work. Build and of course test. Excellent. Start working on the Bitfinex REST API. The build setting up. I added this without doing the tests first. This is bad. It should implement tickers. JSON parsing throwing an error. Bad. Ticker names. Right, I now have a pending test. I will leave it here for now. And not send it off. Great. Great. And at this, I think I'm going to stop for today. Has been very nice. I'm too tired. See you next time.